So our vision here at St. Paul's is always to love God, to welcome everyone, and to make a difference, right? So again, these are the three things that we always try to do. We do that with our pillars that we have with building our own personal relationship with Christ, our community, and also like living the gospel, our relationship with each other, as well as making doing operational excellence. And to be a healthy church, all this is to become a healthy church. A healthy church is a church that confesses. So this year, our theme is freedom through confession. And so far, we've been talking about why. Why should I do this practice? Well, many reasons, actually. It's for our own healing, for our own freedom, forgiveness, cleansing. It cultivates humility. It's for our own self-awareness, guidance, overcome sin, accountability, to renew baptism. And the last reason that we're going to give for the whys is it's commanded. And frankly, you could have just did this as one and that's it. Because if Christ commanded it or God commanded it, then our response is we should follow it. But I put it last. I put it last because there's so many other things that's benefiting us that I wanted to put that ahead. But again, it is. As James says, confess your sins to one another. And then it went from one another to the priest. And again, if we are confess our sins, that's our theme verse of the year. If we confess our sins, he's faithful and just and will forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So again, it's first confess, then the cleansing. So Jesus, we're going to do this in a few weeks. We are going to first wash the feet and then we celebrate the divine liturgy. And that's the pattern. So the step is always repent, confess, and then the washing comes, then we partake as well. So this is as far back as the earliest writing, which is the writings of the Didache. The writings of the church apostles said this: confess your sins in church. Do not go up to your prayer with an evil conscience. This is the way of life. On the Lord's day, gather together, break bread, give thanks after confessing your transgressions, so that your sacrifice may be pure. So these are the steps that the church has given us, and these are what we do.